All right, good evening, one and all. And here comes your challenge in queues, a data structure. So this is what I want you to guys to implement. You have to mimic a printer. You have to mimic the characteristic of a printer. So you have to create a data structure known as queue, which will hold jobs like job one, job two. So this jobs has following attributes. Let me just say what you want to do. So you have to write three classes. Let me, of course, make it like a full screen and we'll code it up. So you have to make like three classes. So the first class has to be printQueue. This printQueue is basically a data structure queue, right? So this is the data structure. There should be a class known as jobs. And we need a class known as printer. The job should have following attributes. It should have an attribute known as pages. Then it should have an attribute known as print page to print the pages. Remember that. And we have to check if it is complete. Now coming to the printer class, it should have the following attributes: get jobs. So this is your stack, basically your queue. So all the characteristics of queue and the printer. All right, so it's kind of a little laggy right now. So let's come to the code. So the printer would have a get job and a print job. So let me go back. So this is how everything should work together, or it's tied together. So your task is like something like this. So you have a queue here. You pass in the jobs, which is an object, right? This job, let's say this has like 5 pages to print. This has 10 pages to print. Now, this is your data structure. So you created this class. You created this queue. You encode everything here. Then this is the printer class. This is your printer. So the printer should have, as I said, an attribute known as get jobs. So the get jobs will get the first job that was in the queue. After getting the job, you should be able to print the job. So the print job, what it will do is basically internally call jobs, and so this will call print jobs and print the pages and check if it is complete. This is how the architecture looks like. I mean, this is how you should like code. Now let's see the actual software or the code which will mimic the printer class. All right. Being very slow, and we'll go very slow. We have a printer print queue, which is nothing but a queue data structure. So make sure to check the queue data structure first if you do not know what it is. So similarly, we have NQ, DQ is empty. We discussed that in the first part. Now here is the thing, job. As I said, remember, the job has pages in it. So we have pages. I'm initializing randomly pages from 1 to 11, any number of pages. It has a method known as print page, which will basically print the pages. Here you can see if the self.page is greater than 0, that means there is actual a page. Then print the page and decrement the page. That's what it does. Then check complete. So it basically checks if the job is complete, whether the printing is complete or not. Coming to your printer class, we have a method known as get jobs, which will get the jobs from the queue, as I just explained you. This is our queue, which has an objects of job one, job two. This is the object. It will pop the object, first object, that is job one. So that is nothing but, in my case, print queue. So printQ.dq, we are calling the stack method, queue method, dq, so we can pop that job, right? Now, that is nothing but the get job method. We have a print job, which is has to print the job. So we'll say while job.pages is greater than 0, remember self.currentJob, we dq the job, so this will contain a job, right? So job.pages is greater than 0. job.printPage, so this job.printPage, remember this job is an object, print page is a method here, it's gonna come here, and call this method. So it's going to print the pages. Once all the printing of all the pages is done, we have to see if it is complete. If it is complete, you have to say printing complete, else an error. Remember, again, it's a little complicated. Again, the code is there in the GitHub. Make sure to check that out. Go ahead, read it, learn it, play with it. So this is how you'll be better programmers. So this is how the entire code looks like. We have a queue method, we have a job method, we have a printer object. Let's look at the driver program. So I create the objects. So put some new jobs on the queue. So job.printPages and job.checkComplete. Initially, job.printPages would be zero, null, because we haven't, there is nothing on the queue. CheckPages similarly will check it is complete or not. Since there is nothing on the queue, it's going to give false. Now put the job on the queue. So I call the printQueue.nQueue method and I pass the object to it. So it's going to store an object in the stack, which is right here. So job one. Then what I do is printQueue.item. So I'm printing the list whether that job is there or not. So it should give me an address. Call the printer to get the job. So printer.getJobs, and I'm passing the printQueue. So this will dequeue the job from the this. So this job will be dequeue for the printer object. So get jobs. After doing the jobs, I'm printing the items to make sure that there are no items. Since there is only one job in the queue, this should be empty. Remember, then I say printer.printJobs, then printer.currentJobs. So I'm passing the current jobs. And once the printing is done, it should give us print complete. Let's run it. So let's see what we get. So this has 7 pages randomly initialized, right? So initially there is no page, there are no pages, so it's none. Check it if it's complete. There is no job, so it's false. We put the first job on the queue. We check the items, so it gives an address. That's correct. Printer.getJobs. So this will dequeue the job, right? Then printerQueue.item. So it is checking the item. Since we dequeue it, we removed the jobs. This should give us a null value. So this is what it gave. And we are calling the print function, so which is basically decrementing the number of pages. So once the printing is done, it says print complete. That's it for this video. Hope you have enjoyed this. Might be a little complicated. Make sure to check that out, code out. Make sure to read it, draw it out, understand it, and play with it. So thank you for watching. Once again, we'll see you guys in the next video where we would be learning more complex stuff in the Python, that is data structures and stuff. We'll practice this a lot. So thank you for watching.